Okay, I want to show you guys how to install libraries to your distribution of Arduino. And the reason for this is that there's these options down here at the bottom that allow you to use displays selectors. It's basically these little heads-up displays that'll give you the temperature and allow you to select different files from your SD card. Most of these use different libraries that aren't included in the distribution of Arduino that you're going to download. So what I'm using with mine is the Sane Smart, which is the most popular version of the display available. And like I said before in previous videos, they've got really good documentation in this firmware. So they basically tell you where to go. They say, you have to use this library. Well, they don't tell you how to install the library. So a good thing to do would be just go ahead and cut and paste this and go to the website. I'm already on the website. So for this, we need to use a version of Liquid Crystal library, which controls the LCD display that is for an I2C. Now, this I2C library for Liquid Crystal isn't included by default with the distribution of Arduino that I've downloaded for my distribution of Linux. So what you're going to need to do is copy this into your distribution of Arduino, and if you're like me and you installed your distribution from the package manager, this means you're going to have to find your distribution in order to be able to put the library in, because it'll install it to different locations on your hard drive just depending on what distribution it is and which flavor of Linux you're running. So the best way to do this is to just go ahead and go to the link in the on the in the firmware, and you're going to click on the download section. For me, for this library, this is how you find this zip. So you download their zip and save it to someplace you know where it's at. And the easiest way to figure out where your Arduino distro is to type where is Arduino. And what this is going to do is it's going to give you a lot of different locations where it finds Arduino. So it's got it says Arduino is in all these different places. We've got user bin, user bin X11, user share, and user share man, and these are the man pages. Well, on my version, this is where the libraries are installed. So basically, you've got your path there, CD into your path. Okay, and get a directory listing, and you'll see that libraries is under the libraries heading. All right, so we're in the libraries section, and as you can see, we already have the Liquid Crystal library installed. However, we don't have the Liquid Crystal I2C version. So, with your recently downloaded library, what you're going to want to do is, in order to install this, you're going to need super user privileges. So doing this from the command line is recommended, unless you're in Windows, in which case you can simply just install it to your libraries folder. But for Linux, we're going to have to do this from the command line. And I've already done this, but this is the command that you need to ex execute. Sudo means you're executing it as super user, and since this is a zip, we're going to have to use the unzip utility. Specify the name of your zip, and then we use dash d to specify the directory we are unzipping to. And as we found earlier, our libraries folder is in user share Arduino and libraries. So you simply type this all in, and it's going to unzip it for you. Now, some of the libraries have already been in place. Now, you're going to want to go ahead and upgrade all of the libraries to be compatible. There might be some changes that aren't in your version, and your libraries might not work very well. That you might have to go in and modify it by hand. Just go ahead and override everything. You're going to be good to go. Okay, now once you've uploaded your once you've installed your library, you're going to have to restart your Arduino distribution. This is because it loads the available libraries into a file whenever you start the IDE up, and they're not available to you if you've already got your Arduino IDE open. So now that we've got everything installed, we can go down and go to our configuration, scroll down to the bottom, and find your LCD that you're using. Like I said, I'm using the SaneSmart I2C. This will be commented out. If you're using a different display, then you just go ahead and comment out the display that you're using. And of course, download the library that corresponds to the display that you're going to use. So after we've installed the library, all we do is simply uncomment out the define for our particular display, and we can verify and upload our sketch. So before I had the library installed, I had a lot of errors, and it would tell me that the library wasn't available. So now that you've got the library installed, you can go ahead and upload your firmware and have fun using your new LCD display after you have plugged it together. And I'll show you how to plug it up to your controller board in another video. So thanks.